Hi Capricorn, welcome to your 2017 love reading with Island Girl Tarot. I certainly hope everyone is enjoying their birthday month and had a great new year and has gotten New Year's off to the good start. I know Mercury's in retrograde. I hope it has been kind to you. I understand they're having some major issues with, or had some major issues with customs here in the States, and that was just a Mercury retrograde dictionary picture right there. So, if you're interested in a private reading with me, it's Island Girl Tarot at 2000. It's Island. Can't even talk. IslandGirl2008@gmail.com. That's IslandGirl with two L's on the end of girl, 2008@gmail.com. And you can also find me on my Facebook page, Island Girl Tarot. And I will be doing a live draw 10:30 Saturday morning, okay, off of my Facebook page. So if you're in the chat room, I'll draw a card for you. All right, with that said, Capricorn, let's get right to your love reading for January 2017 for our Capricorn friends. Ooh. The bottom of the deck is the High Priestess. So secrets revealed, things to be unearthed. Let's see what we have going on here. Well, Capricorn, it looks to me like in the past you all have just, it's lackluster is just the best way to put it, just lacking. When the Five of Pentacles comes out in the love reading, it typically means a lack of emotion, a lack of fulfillment, a lack of love, a lack of feeling loved. And it looks to me like you were tired of being trapped by all of this negative energy. And you turned around and you walked away. Now, having walked away has presented some problems. It looks like perhaps maybe again the Five of Pentacles comes in that you've walked away and now it's not as easy to maintain your household lifestyle. And those kinds of things with the Nine of Swords here is what's keeping you up at night. But fear not, you have some really good cards. The Knight of Swords is coming in, and that is an air sign, and he is either an Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra, and it's a younger person. It's, you know, a millennial is the way that I'd characterize them, somewhere towards 30, but this person is going to come in with a solution. He's in action, so there's going to be some sort of action that's going to come in that's going to help you alleviate the staying up at night. Because right underneath the Knight of Swords, we've got the Wheel of Fortune, which is your karma card. And it's also, so whatever you're going through right now is clearing out karma. You're dealing and closing off some old karmic issues. And so that when the wheel in the newness begins again, you're going to have a clean slate to go on. Okay, Capricorn? And believe me, it's coming. The Fool was the last card. And he is obviously new beginnings, new adventures, beginning again. And next to him was the Ten of Wands. And that just clearly tells you you're almost to the end of your nightmare journey here. Here, let me put these three up together. This nightmare journey here that's keeping you up at night and everything that you've been through and all of the crap that you're carrying with you and the baggage and problems and debts and everything else. But you're almost done. Believe me, with the Wheel of Fortune and the Fool together, that is definitely a karmic clearing. It's a way to begin again, and you're going to have the opportunity. But realize it's not necessarily on your timeline. You're going to have to be patient. You need to meditate. Go within. If you're very anxious about all of this, go within. Listen to your spirit guides. Listen to your innermost self, because your higher self, your intuition knows exactly what's going on with you, and just know that you will be provided for. As scary as everything is, you will somehow be able to make things work, okay? And that, again, with the High Priestess being the last card and the overall energy of the deck, I really feel like it's telling you that if you are in a weird spot, if you've broken up with somebody, if you're really scared, you need to look within, begin a spiritual journey, start meditating, you know, buy a deck of tarot cards or runes or something, and just to activate your inner floor, your inner being, so that you won't feel like you're dropping into a bottomless pit. Because once your inner being, your inner spiritual being is activated, that's your catch. That's your, it's literally like an IVC filter. It'll catch you. And so you're in, so then you know deep down inside that you're not going to be alone forever. And that there is a path. Because what happens if you're looking for a twin flame, or if you've broken up with somebody and you're not feeling like you're ever going to find the right person, in order to manifest the right person in your life, you have to be right with yourself. And because it does you no good if the perfect person comes in and you're a mess. I mean, come on. So I think if you have gone through something, or if you're in, that could also be what a lot of this is maybe this has not happened yet, and you all are really thinking about how to get out of your trap and feeling trapped emotionally in an emotional relationship, or perhaps even an abusive relationship. But you are going to walk away, and you will have that catch. You will have that guard down there, but you have to go within for it. You know, it's not a whole lot of love and romance in this reading. I do show the Six of Swords is the center of the reading, and it is definitely saying you're moving into calmer waters. You're on the right path. Again, if you don't, you know, and if you're coupled in a couple's relationship with all of this, well, then this just means you guys have had words, you've got issues, there's debts, there's issues with kids, there's just stuff that's piling on, and it feels like it's a very, very big burden. Same thing applies. Go within, develop that floor in your soul so that you can feel like you're going to get caught and that you're not just sinking into a deep abyss, because you're not. You're there. Your spirituality, your ability to handle and maintain emotions and handle situations as they arise, especially if you're already in a relationship and you've got outside extraneous influences and people trying to muck with it, you need to have your solid footing of yourself, because then that way your partner can believe in your solid footing and that helps them as well. And that's the other thing. If you're going into a, if you begin to, and in that, I just happened to look right underneath the High Priestess, and the next card in the deck was the Magician. So that's definitely saying manifestation, what you think you will manifest. But you've got to go within, and you've got to connect to yourself. Like I said, I'm sorry it doesn't look like, you know, there's, you know, there are new beginnings out there if you are not currently in a relationship. And if you are, there are, what I would say with the Fool and the Ten of Wands and the Eight of Swords is you're going to have to figure out a new way of looking at things in order to unburden yourself. There's got to be a new avenue or how a new way of communication even. And that's what a lot of this, there's a lot of swords in this reading, and that's has to do with communications and thought processes. And it looks like you all may have had issues come up and you guys are not on the same page about how to deal with them. The one good thing the Ten of Wands shows us is whatever issues there are and wherever you may be in your relationship or looking for a relationship, you're almost towards the finish line. So just keep going. You're really close. Okay, well, I hope this resonates or with you guys, Capricorn. Like I said, I'm sorry it's not all hearts and shamrocks and that kind of thing, but it does look like that there's, in any relationship, communication is paramount. And if you can't talk to each other and if you can't find a way to speak to one another, then there's no way that the relationship is going to work. So that, I think, is what's really, really, really being said, is if you're already in a relationship, look to that communication, find new and different ways to communicate. And then if you're not, you need to go on your own spiritual process and get yourself right before you invite somebody else in to your into your life. So, all right, Capricorn, take care. I'm going to come out on the 15th with the financials. I'm sorry these are a little late, but with all the craziness with me traveling and everything, I just couldn't get everything done. So take care. Again, it's islandgirl2008@gmail.com, and I hope you all have a great January. Bye, Capricorn. Happy birthday.